Hey, Eddie Fish. It's the 11th of July, 7-11, 2018. And man, I've been trying to get to this just to share with you what's being shown to us and what's coming. Okay, I showed you this article, right, that I saw at the same time as this one with the opening of the pit. Well, this one displays it even more detailed. But of course, it's hidden, it's turned upside down, it's just to mock the sleeping world, to mock God, okay? When all along, it's exactly what's in that image is told to us openly and honestly in the Holy Bible. The locusts of Revelation 9 are being displayed plainly in this image, but they hide it. It's just the opposite of God, okay? So, I mean, I saw this quite some time ago, didn't really know what to do with it, to be honest with you. It's pretty crazy stuff. But I showed you, you know, Ooze Boy Valley, 888, same as Jesus on the cross, 888. And these people, this NASA is an evil entity, people. I mean, that's all you really need to know. You can't trust them as far as you can spit, not even that far. I'm just telling you. You can't let any man lead you. You need to be led by the Word of God and the Holy Spirit. Nothing else can be trusted. And when you encounter other people who indwell that Holy Spirit, you know it. It's an intuitive thing. You know what I'm saying? There's a conviction that comes along with indwelling the Holy Spirit. There's an understanding that is given unto you that gives you that peace and understanding of what's going on in the world. And this stuff is about to break loose. I mean, that's all I can really tell you because I don't know when. You know, this is all under the hand of God. But Satan, right here in this image, is telling this is coming. He knows what's coming just as well as God does. But it's all offered right here, free for the taking, with love in the Holy Bible. That's all you need to do is get into the Word of God and pray that the truth be revealed to you. Humbly, sincerely, okay? So the whole locus of Revelation 9 are in this image, right? We can go through it right down the list, okay? Now, I had to pull the image and put it into this editor that sometimes it behaves, sometimes it don't. And right now it seems to be behaving, okay? So there's the image right there, okay? It's the same exact image. Anybody can grab this and look at this too. If you're so inclined, please do. There's so much in this image that there's no way I can cover it all. No way. Not in one video. But there's so much being told here that we already know, but the world doesn't. Those of you who don't know Christ, I mean, this is important because it's tangible proof to show you that these things are real. This spiritual war that is literally for your eternal soul is real, and you need to pay attention to it. You need to humble yourself and ask God in heaven, please show me the truth. Okay? So here's the image, and of course, the first thing that I ever do with these is I turn them upside down, because that's what they do. Isaiah 29:16. Okay, so we turn it upside down, and right away, I just want to show you the overall shape here, okay? If you just look at this image, you can actually see that there is a face here, okay? And I'm going to show you all this stuff, but I want you to see the overall image. If you look at this shape right here, see, these are legs right here. This is the front end of a horse shape, okay? And this is probably the most distorted part of the whole image, okay? And this running off here, where you see my cursor here, that's a wing going off there. That is a wing. This is the face. And this is the body of the horse. Okay? That's, like I say, that's like the hardest one to see. But it's there, trust me. The shapes of the locusts are like on the horses, okay? Prepared unto battle. And on their heads, as it were, crowns like gold. And their faces were as the faces of men, okay? So if we take this image and we just skew it a little bit, about 40 degrees, we start to see everything on here. And I'm going to show you all of it. So the face of the man, you just saw that. Clear as day. This is the exact image. And there's our face of the man. Boom. Right there. And it's probably about as perfect as you could ever ask for. I mean, it's undeniable, unmistakable. So there's your face of the man, right? And he had a crown of gold. Well, this right here is his crown of gold. And I'm going to show you what that is. This is portraying the Nephilim, if you will. These are the creatures that were here before the flood, as in the days of Noah. And that's what's coming out of the pit, okay? Hybrid creatures that are not going to be pleasant. You just got to understand this. And this right here, this serpent, this chapiter or whatever you call it, you know, a crown. Because if we look at the word crown, right, we see that it's not necessarily like a round, you know, like we would think of a crown. It's more of a symbol of honor, generally, a chapiter, a badge of royalty, okay? We could go into the more details of it, but this is a crown. I mean, that's just what it is, you guys, okay? Let me see if I can, there we go. Right there, and it is actually, if we look into this little area here, you're going to see that there is a literal serpent in there. You can make this little fella out, his little eye, his mouth right there. Very, very hidden in there. But that is what that is. That's what that represents. Okay? I'm just telling you, this is what you're looking at. Is one of these. Okay? Face of the man with the crown. What else do we got here? And they had hair as the hair of women. And their teeth were as the teeth of lions. Okay? Look at right here. That is hair like a woman flowing off there. Now, don't laugh because I'm not good at these lines. But there you go. Face of the man. The crown of gold. The hair of a woman. Okay? What else did he have? And teeth of lions. They have hair of a woman and teeth as if the teeth of lions. Look at this stuff, right? If you look right here, right next to the face itself, right? See, there's the profile of the face. Right next to the face. Look at that. That is the face of a lion. And I'll show them to you. Let me take this off. And let me take this off. And I'll show you the lion. Right there. The face of a lion. And the teeth of a lion. That's the whole point right there, is this wide open mouth full of teeth. A lion. So there's your man, your teeth of the lion, your hair of the woman. I mean, this is crazy. It's all right here. They have breastplates of iron. The sound of their wings was the sound of chariots. I showed you the wings. And they had tails like unto scorpions. This is crazy. I mean, look right up behind the lion right here, right? See right up here? As if it comes like right from behind the lion, and it's just crazy. This is the tip of the stinger right here. Scorpion tail right there. Let me take the lion off, and there it is. I mean, just, you can't get around this stuff. So we're being shown through NASA's images of so-called Mars, okay, which is a whole nother story. The Earth doesn't move, people. Space is not what NASA tells you. They can't go there, you can't go there, we can't go there. It's sealed off from us, okay? You got to wrap your head around this stuff, okay? So there's everything there. Everything is right there. I mean, I just have to show you this stuff, you know what I mean. And they had a king over them. Apollyon, right? NASA. Well, what do we know about NASA? What was their most famous mission? Apollo. Apollo 11, to be exact, when they supposedly went to the moon. This is crazy. And it just so happens that the thing launched, right, on July 16th, coming up in a week, 1969. At 1332, it launched. 49 years ago. 7 times 7, right? So all this stuff comes into play. Everything does. But you know, you just got to look and understand that, you know, there's a spiritual war going on. And these entities are not playing games. They know how to manipulate. They know how to steer you through temptation if you're not solid in Christ and walking in His Holy Spirit. You just have to be there. Or this stuff will literally overtake you and consume you. Okay, there's no fear in any of this when you're in Christ. So you need to really seek Him. That is the number one priority. Because this stuff is just completely undeniable, you guys. I mean, at this point in time, if we start picking and poking and denying this stuff, it's going to be too late. It will. It'll be too late for you. Your soul is at stake here. So unless you want to experience these creatures coming out of the pits of hell, okay, and tormenting you for 5 months, because that's what they'll do, okay, you'll want to die, but you won't be able to die. Death shall flee from them. Think about that. Do you really want to experience that? When all you got to do is ask Jesus into your heart, okay, knowing that you're in a dark and pretty hopeless world without Him. He's the only Savior. He's the only way out. No man can fix this. It just can't happen. And also, I need to show you this stuff. It's just in me to show it to you. So there you have it. I mean, in the Ooze Boy Vallis on the planet of Mars, which, by the way, is supposed to be doing some dazzling things coming up this week, I guess. All kinds of craziness going on with Mars. I don't really follow that stuff, but praise God for those of you who do pay attention to the planets and the stars. We all give our portion. We all throw what's given to us on the table, and eventually we start seeing the big picture form before us. But you must be in Christ and you must be in the Word of God in order to understand the time you're in and the seriousness of this, because it's coming. In God's time, but He's given us more signs than, I mean, come on, folks. Get with the program. Seek Jesus, I'm just telling you. I had to show you this stuff because it's just the way it is. All in there, every single bit of it. I'll link everything. You can grab this image and look at it if you want. And there's tons more in this image that I want to share with you because this tells a big story, folks. This is the stuff that's coming on this earth. It's coming, and it's coming soon, and you need to get right with Jesus. You just do, okay? So I'll leave you with that, and I'll get back to this in another time. I'm glad this worked for us here for this video. So, you know, peace and grace to you all, sincerely. Benny Fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,